In today's video, we'll be looking at my remake of Swedish House Mafia's Greyhound, produced by Axwell, Sebastian Ingrosso, and Steve Angello. Here's the project file inside of Ableton. The tempo of the song is 125 beats per minute, and the key signature is G major. The elements that make up this track is the big punchy kick, the main lead sound, the secondary lead sound in the second half of the drop, the various bass sounds, and the additional synth sounds that you hear throughout the track. First, we have the lead sound. Here's the MIDI for it. This is what it sounds like. I'll mute all the processing. To achieve this sound, all I did was have pretty much a saw wave with an additional layer that's kind of in between a triangle and a square. And this is what it sounds like. As far as processing goes, there's quite a bit, but it's all subtle. The first thing I have is a transient shaper, just to add a bit more attack and body to the sound. Then I just gave it a little bit of compression. Next, I EQ'd out the low end and I tamed to just a bit of the high end. I put some overdrive lightly on it just to give it a bit more grit. And then this goes into FabFilter Saturn to give it a bit more saturation, mainly on the high end. And in parallel, I have a reverb. This is a very short reverb, less than 1 second, and it kind of just gives it space around the lead sound. Next, I took out a bit of the very high end of the sound, and then halfway through the drop, I just cut out some of the low end with an automation. And then lastly, just one additional EQ to clean up all the processing that came beforehand. And then I have it just sidechaining with an LFO tool. Next, we have this offbeat sound that you hear playing along with the lead. It just hits a G note. This is what it sounds like. For this sound, I'm using Spire, and it's just this preset called Lead Blunt Saw. For this sound, I added a transient shaper to make it hit harder. I have a reverb in parallel. For the reverb, I have a little plate, 2 seconds decay, and then I actually put overdrive after the reverb to gritty up the reverb sound a bit. And then lastly, there's just an EQ to clean up some of the low end and tame a bit of the high end. And then an additional filter to tame out the very high end. Next, we have the sub sound. This is the MIDI for it. It's pretty much following the main lead melody. For this sound, I just have a simple sine wave inspire. And then for the processing, I just have Kick Tight, which is a preset under Corpus, and I tuned it with this knob to G, which is the key of the song. This gives it a bit more body to it without it and with it. And then with the EQ, I just cut out everything above 100. And then there's an LFO sidechain it to the kick. Next, there's a growl sound, and this is layered with a open hat sound as well. This is what the growl bass sounds like. This is the MIDI for it. This sound is coming from Serum. It's a preset called Bass Bites. This is what it sounds like without the processing. For this, I put overdrive on it, followed by a saturator, and then I compress the sound a bit. This is followed by EQ, which is cutting out a lot of the low end and taming some of the high end. This transient shaper on all three bands is adding some attack, with the middle to high end getting the most, and then just a little bit of attack on the low end. And then this is followed by yet another EQ, which is gently taming some of these frequencies to fit with the mix. And then this auto filter is just filtering out most of the high end of the sound. And then lastly, there's a reverb on it, and this just gives it some more space, and it's very short, 0.5 seconds. And then this layer on top of it is just an open hi-hat. So this is the two sounds together. Next, we have the Yoi sound. I got this from a Virtual Riot sample pack. This is what it sounds like. And then I just took that, and throughout the song, I cut it up into smaller pieces and reversed it, because throughout the drop, you hear different variations of this Yoi in the original. Next, we have the kick drum. During the turnaround of the drop, at the end of 8 bars, there's a little tom sound that you hear. It's just two different toms. After 8 bars, a ride comes in, and this just adds to the energy of the track and keeps it going. So now, leading up into the second half of the drop, a few more elements get added into it, and this just keeps the energy going and makes it sound bigger. This additional lead sound gets layered with the original. It sounds like this. This is just playing the same melody as the lead sound. For this sound, I started off from scratch within Serum. It's very simple. It's just two square waves, but on one of the oscillators, you pitch it up an octave. And then the envelope shaping down here at the bottom left is very quick sound. And it's also, the voicing is in mono. This is what it sounds like without the processing. For the processing, it's very similar to the lead sound, except I took out, I believe, just one thing. There's the overdrive, the saturation, compression. The main lead sound is dead center mono, but this additional layer is actually a bit more stereo if you listen to it. So for that, I just used simple delay and did a bit of a Haas effect. So here's it more in mono. And here's it in stereo. And it's the same LFO tool sidechaining as the main lead sound. An additional synth hit sound gets added. It sounds like this. It just sounds like a sonar sound. And in Serum, there's actually a preset called FX Submarine, which nails the sound. There's just a filter on it to cut out the high end, and then an additional EQ to fit it in the mix. An additional bass sound is added. It's more of a mid-bass sound. This is what it sounds like. For this sound, I just went into Spire and I chose the brass 2 setting on oscillator 1. And then I just turned down all of the envelope shaping except for the decay. I brought it up a little bit, so it's a very short, punchy sound. And then the EQ is just taking out the lows and the highs out of it just to have that mid sound. And then the same LFO tool sidechaining it. The additional percussion added in the second half is this mix of a clap and a tom. It sounds like this. I actually had to use 3 sounds for it. I used a tom sound, a clap, and a bass shot sound. And I layered them all together. And the EQing is just to shape all the sounds together so they fit nicely. And it's panned a little to the left. There is a hi-hat playing on the offbeat. Sounds like this. And then in the second half of the drop, every 8 bars, there's a big snare sound and a crash that leads into it. This is what it sounds like. And then some sound effects get introduced. There's a sweep sound. And for this, I just layered 3 Vengeance sweep sounds. And And then right before the turnaround, after 8 bars, there's a sub drop when everything gets taken out of the track. And then leading into the next 8 bars, there's another down sweep, but it's a more high pitch frequency sound like this. And then leading to the end of the whole drop, there's a high energy sweep going up. Sounds like this. So this is what the final result sounds like. I have the original audio in there just to lead up into the drop and then to fill in that part that goes in between both drops. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, click the bell to get notifications, and if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel.